up on your feet. What you mean to do is catch up with her. Bounce, bang, get up on your feet and help me get it.
The Duchess of Cambridge, Chamel Turlan, a Greek goddess last night as she stepped out for a glittering gala dinner at the Royal Palace in Norway. Pregnant Kate, 36, stole the show in a blush pink gown by Alexander McQueen with crystal flower embellishment on the neckline. She added extra glamour with jaw-dropping diamond earrings and the bracelet the Queen wore on her wedding day. Kate and William travelled to Oslo earlier on Thursday and spent the evening enjoying an official dinner with their Norwegian counterparts. Ahead of the glittering event, they posed for a photo with King Harald and Queen Sylvia and were reunited with Crown Prince Haakon and his wife McMarit after spending the afternoon together at a technology event. Princess McMarit also looked stunning in an embellished silver gown, wearing her blonde hair swept back in a chic updo. They were also joined by Prince Haakon's sister Princess Martha Louise, who opted for a black halter neck gown with tiered ruffles, and Princess Astrid, the older sister of King Harald V. Kate, who is 6 months pregnant, divided opinion when she stepped out in a blue Erden dress for an event in Stockholm on Wednesday, just a day after she donned an all-over floral print, fluted sleeves and a ruffled detailed bodice and collar by the same designer. The dresses have been a departure from her usual choice of chic dresses with clean lines and minimal patterns. But fans haven't been sure what to make of the new look, with some declaring the golden Erden dress she wore at Old and Frumpy. With William in the seat of a high-tech exercise bike, a video showing a detailed drive around the streets of the university town of Street. Andrews were shown, reminding them of their familiar sights, dot with Kate, 36, and Prince Haakon and Princess McMarit looking on. William operated the controls and soon spotted his room at St. Salvator's Halls of Residence, where both he and Kate stayed in their first year. "You are bringing us down memory lane," Kate told CEO of Mottetic John Ingrid Jeans. William was enthusiastic, James Alice got to you straight away while we were filming, and said you filmed my room. Apostrophe to a soundtrack of Coldplay, Linkin Park and Ellie Goulding's Your Song, which she sung at the couple's 2011 wedding. The film showed a cafe called The North Point, which displayed a sign saying that William met Kate here for coffee. James asked him if it was true. He said, "Of course, St. Andrews is a very small place. I took it to mean they have been everywhere." Apostrophe, the MotiView technology, which was shown off during a visit by the two royal couples to a group of startup companies operating in Norway, is designed to aid those suffering from dementia and also help them exercise. Their unique films are created with customers, so that they can be most poignant, such as when user grew up, and also increase activity. Soon after they'd arrived at Mesh in Central Oslo, the royal couples sat at a table to try out Remarkable, a digital template-style device that users can scribble on using a special pen. Kate wrote, "Does this feel like paper?" and she drew a tree. William wrote, "I love Norway. My toes are numb." And he added a smiley face. The Norwegian Crown Prince wrote, "So cool to write on a tablet with a pen." Apostrophe CEO Magnus Wanberg says, "The tablet is designed around reading, writing, and sketching." "It is specialized for those who like paper." The Duke said, "This feels very natural." Apostrophe. They were then taken to meet the innovators of a little robot-like gadget called AV1, which enables the classroom to be live-streamed to children who may be off school and feeling isolated from their friends and teachers. Clearly getting on well together, the royal party spent about an hour at Mesh, seeing the various startups and chatting to entrepreneurs. The palace had said that, because of a desire to ensure the pace of the day was right for 6 months pregnant Kate, she was not going to attend. But that decision was reversed as she ended her walkabout with William and the Norwegian couple in the sculpture park. Towards the end of the visit, the couples took part in a friendly game of Kahoot. William and Princess McMarrett played on one team, while Kate and the Prince Håkon on the other, answering a series of questions like, "Is it true that the Norwegian royal family eat English dessert, plum pudding at Christmas?" As one of the founders, Johan Brand, asked the question, McMarrett called out yes. As the game progressed, it became clear Kate's side was falling behind by at least 1,500. "We didn't hear that," Brand joked when he was told the latest scores. "That was so much fun," Brand says. "They have a voice, and they use it. They were all very approachable, and seem very interested, and that's inspiring for people." Apostrophe. While neither team won, William and McMarrett came out on top among the royals. William's trip this week comes exactly 34 years after his mother, Princess Diana, was hosted by King Harold V and Queen Sonja on a two-day solo visit to the country in 1984. Earlier, the couple explored Oslo during the final leg of their royal tour after being forced to cancel engagement this morning in Stockholm due to heavy snow. Temperatures plummeted to below freezing in the region overnight, with snowfall expected throughout the morning, forcing the royal couple and their entourage to fly instead from Stockholm's Arlanda Airport. After they were on a visit to Sweden, the royals kicked off 2 days in Norway this afternoon with lunch at Oslo's Royal Palace, followed by a walkabout in the palace grounds with the royal family. The Duchess, who is 7 months pregnant, braved the icy Nordic conditions and vertiginous heels to slay Lady Catherine Walker Costigan, and William were greeted by Crown Prince Håkon and his wife, Crown Princess Mette-Marit, on a red carpet rolled out across the tarmac at Gardermoen Airport. After arriving at the palace for lunch with King Harald III and Queen Sonja, Kate, 36, removed her coat to reveal a £169 cobalt blue maternity dress from Seraphine featuring a lace bodice and frilled sleeves. She later warded off the Arctic chill in what is believed to be a sumac £225 Lacquerini luxury alpaca fur hat as she chatted to members of the public during a quick walk about outside the palace, joined by Håkon and Mette-Marit's daughter Princess Ingrid Alexandra, 14, and finally swapped her heels for a pair of sturdy riding boots. In the palace, the two families exchanged gifts with Kate and William providing their hosts with a signed portrait, while the Norwegian king and queen gave them books, an ornamental bell, a framed portrait, and a set of cozy woolly jumpers. Following lunch, the couple were given a tour of the Princess Ingrid Alexandra Sculpture Park within the palace gardens, Slottsparken, which opened last year, to mark the 25th anniversary of 80-year-old King Harald III's reign, and is named after the young princess. Temperatures plummeted to below freezing in the region overnight with snowfall expected throughout the morning, forcing the royal couple and their entourage to fly instead from Stockholm's Arlanda Airport. Announcing the last-minute change of plan in the early hours of Thursday morning, Kensington Palace said, "Unfortunately, the snowy weather in Stockholm today has meant that TRH's travel plans have had to be changed." This morning's engagement at Uppsala Air Base will not go ahead. In a speech on Wednesday night, William said he had been looking forward to the scheduled visit to Uppsala Air Base, located an hour north of the Swedish capital. Speaking at a reception at Stockholm's Fotografiska Gallery, told his hosts, "Your security concerns are ours, and it is hugely important that we continue to work ever more closely together to reduce threats." The couple were set to receive a short briefing on the Swedish Armed Forces' operational capabilities at Uppsala this morning, before viewing some of the Gripen aircraft of the type deployed by Sweden as its commitment to the Joint Expeditionary Force. The briefing, led by Defence Minister Peter Hultqvist, went ahead in Stockholm instead. This morning, British Ambassador to Sweden David Cairns tweeted a picture of the Royal Mail's private jet preparing to depart in icy Stockholm Arlanda just before 11 a.m. local time, writing, "Hedged on farewell, number Royal Visit Sweden." Next stop, number Royal Visit Norway. After lunch today, Kate and William met a number of Norwegian and UK companies based at Oslo's first co-working space, Mesh, to hear about how some startups are tackling issues such as the environment and mental health and well-being. The couple will round off their first day in Norway with a dinner at the palace alongside members of government, business leaders and people from the Norwegian creative industries. Friday will begin with a visit to Hartvig Nissen's Hall in Oslo, which was the location for the hugely successful Norwegian television program Skam. Then, the couple will meet the stars and producers of Skam, to hear more about the series, before meeting students to learn about the effect Skam had on bringing challenges teenagers face out into the open, and the role played by social media. Last night Kate wrapped up her last evening in Stockholm in style, donning a blue velvet dress from Urban for an event at Stockholm's Fotografiska Gallery, which boasts glittering views over the city at night. On arrival, the Duchess wrapped up in a black fur-trimmed coat by Swedish designer Ida Storstedt, and wore her locks swept back in an elegant updo, mirroring the hairstyle of Crown Princess Victoria, who looked glamorous in a black satin pencil skirt and red blouse with voluminous sleeves. In a speech at the event, to celebrate Swedish culture, the Duke of Cambridge said he and Kate have been impressed by the inspiring Swedish lifestyle that encourages children to play outdoors, whatever the weather. The couple were at the Fotografiska Gallery in Stockholm, where they mingled with guests from the worlds of music, film, TV, art and sport. Earlier on Wednesday, the Duchess of Cambridge displayed her growing baby bump regime, and Prince William were invited for an informal tea party with some of the youngest members of the Swedish royal family. William and Kate met the adorable offspring of Crown Princess Victoria and Prince Daniel, Princess Estelle, 5, and Prince Oscar, who turns 2 in March. After kicking off their second day in Stockholm with a meeting on mental health, they stopped in at Naturskolan Comprehensive School in the city centre. While dozens of pupils waved hand-drawn flags and bunches of flowers, some lucky youngsters managed to get a high five from the Duchess as she greeted the crowds assembled outside. The couple spent around 10 minutes shaking hands with the school children, with William repeatedly telling them, "You've got cold hands," and complimenting them on the flags they were waving. Once inside, the four royals watched pupils at Naturskolan, which has 700 children aged between 6 and 15, take part in a role-playing exercise exploring family problems. They also spent time privately talking to young people about the emotional issues they face.